Hey guys, Lise here from Hustle and Groove, and this is part two of book formatting with Scrivener. So in the last video, we talked about using the compile functionality to format your book. Now, this is a little different. We are going to format using compile as is, which you can see over here on the right-hand side. It is what you do as you go through if you want to keep the formatting as is. So what I mean by that is what you see is what you get. Now, the reason that you might choose to do this versus using the compile as is if you have a lot of subheadings, I guess is the only terminology that I can come up with. So for instance, in this particular book, which is not mine, it's one of my clients, there is a lot of subheadings, and I'm just going to show you what I mean by that. So, all of these here, this is just in the introduction. So, maybe I'll show you what that looks like inside one of these other ones. So, Mitch Matthews is one of my amazing clients, and he wanted to do this book. So, I've been working on this book for him, and it comes out in January 2018. So, if you're watching this and it's after January 2018, you'll be able to get it. It'll be live on Amazon. So, what we've done with this is I've chosen to go compile as is because I wanted a bit more control over how the book looked in the end versus using the compile functionality and letting that override everything in here. Now, the reason I did this is one, there's a lot of quote boxes like this throughout the book. There's lots of variations in font size. And one of the drawbacks of the compile formatting function is that you can't have multiple font sizes. Like it's just going to override everything from within here. The only way around that would be to have multiple documents underneath each one. So every time you wanted a different heading, you would start a new document. Every time you wanted a different subheading, you would start a new document. So it can make your document get quite unwieldy. I'm not sure what the terminology is there, but it gets quite big. And Scrivener can still handle that, but I don't know about you, but my mind, again, I like to keep things simple. So when I was going through this, that was the decision that I made, was to just go, you know what, I'm just going to compile as is. Now, in terms of forcing things to start, like to force a chapter to start on a new page and all those sorts of things, you can manage that by using this thing, which is called a blank page. So all that you do is you would click the plus sign here, and you would call it blank page, and I always put an underscore in just so I know. And then all you need to do is make sure that you copy this and put it in the body, and that's it. You don't need to worry about it doing anything else. So it will just print as a blank page. So the other thing you'll need to remember is to make sure that you compile as is and put page break before so that it doesn't get missed. So that will force an entire blank page with nothing else on it. So I'm just going to delete this one here. So that will force a page in front of this document. So depending on how the book looks when it gets formatted and you see it in the PDF, you can play around and adjust your blank pages in that way. So that's just one thing that you can do. So another reason why you might decide to choose to do compile as is that you want to have a bit more functionality around the images. You want to have a bit more functionality around all the spacing, particularly when it comes to the print book, because maybe you want people to be able to actually physically write, which is exactly what Mitch wanted to do. So that's why you would choose to do compile as is. So if this is ticked, it means what you see is what you get, and it just gives you a bit more control. So those are the two options when it comes to formatting your nonfiction book inside Scrivener, is either using the compile and then the formatting functionality. So you'll see here that I have chosen to include no text whatsoever, and I've unticked the override. So this just happens. I don't have to worry about it. So I just skip over this because I don't need to use it. I can still make adjustments in the transformations area if I wanted to. That will still happen. And same with the page settings, that is still managed from the compile. But in terms of the actual formatting, all done from within the document. So it really comes down to how much control you want and what you're trying to achieve, but those are the two different ways that you can compile and format your book inside Scrivener for print. When it comes to Kindle, you just want to keep things as simple as possible so that when it is viewed on any device, it is readable. If you have any questions at all, you know what to do. Either comment below this blog post, comment below this video, or shoot me an email, lise@hustleandgroove.com.